Okay, that's how you do it. We got a question from the audience here. Anybody?
Yes, I want to know what inspired Magdalene Laundries.
Oh, well, I live in British Columbia as much as I possibly can. Because I'm absent, sometimes I have a man named Hans who he and his family caretake my place. And Hans, sucking on his pipe, said to me one day, "You know, Joni, you're basically a cheerful person, but you write these melancholy songs." He said, "Seems to me that you should write more in the daylight. You're always writing at night." So I sat out in the sun on a rock, and I tuned my guitar to the sound of that day, because I play in open tunings like ragas. So I tuned to the crows and the seagulls and the sonic references available. And it was a fairly cheerful chord progression. You know, well, a little melancholy in it, because beauty has little. But anyway, I intended to write quite a cheery lyric to it. Well, I went to the supermarket to get my groceries, and standing in the line between the Inquirer and the Star was the Vancouver Sun. And I never bought a paper in my life. What possessed me, I don't know. But I picked this paper up, and I never got past the first page. To the left hand of the page was a story that out of Ireland, that the Sisters of Our Lady of Charity outside of Dublin, which was a nunnery, had sold 11 and a half acres to realtors. The realtors, in plowing this land for development, unearthed over 100 bodies in unmarked graves, thus opening up a scandal that had rocked Dublin from, they said, 1800 to 1970. These laundries were closed. Basically, the Magdalene Laundries, which stood outside of, there was every major Irish town and maybe some minor ones, took as slave labor fallen women. Fallen women were classified as the obvious, I guess, prostitutes, unmarried mothers, frequently impregnated by their parish priest, their father, their brother. But the worst of all was that an unmarried woman in her late 20s, if the men of the village were looking at her, she could be deemed a Jezebel by the parishioners and even her own family for her indecisiveness in choosing a mate, and incarcerated for life, or at least until somebody managed to get her out of there. This was cheap labor. Dickensian conditions was the way it was described. Well, you know, there went my cheerful song. So, I mean, this is the story of the Magdalene Laundries. Just turned 27 when they sent me to the sisters for the way men looked at me. Branded as a Jezebel, I knew I was not bound for heaven. I'd be cast in shame into the Magdalene Laundries. Some by their own fathers. Bridget got that belly by her parish priest. We're trying to get things white as snow, all of us woe-begotten daughters, in the steaming stains of the Magdalene Laundries. Temptresses like me, fallen women sentenced into dreamless drudgery. Why do they call this heartless place Our Lady of Charity? Oh, charity.
bloodless brides of Jesus if they had just once glimpsed their room, then they'd know. And they'd drop those stones concealed behind their rosaries. They wilt the grass they walk upon. They leech the light out of a room. They'd like to drive us down the drain at the Magdalene laundries. Peg O'Connell died today. She was a cheeky girl, a flirt. They just stuffed her in a hole. Surely to God you'd think at least some bells should ring. One day I'm gonna die here too, and they'll plant me in the dirt like some lame bulb that never blooms come any spring. Oh, not any spring. Not in this bin. Not in this bin.